In the last video, we have learned about the Bell states or an entanglement. In this video, we will do an application of entanglement known as superdense coding. In superdense coding, we can send from one place to another two classical bits by sending a single quantum bit. So the story is like this, that there are two parties, say party A and party B, or Alice and Bob. And first of all, Alice and Bob get together and they prepare a Bell state. So this circuit here is making a Bell state. We have seen this circuit in one of our previous videos. Afterwards, when they have the Bell state, then they take their portion of Bell state and move away from each other. So Alice take first qubit and move to maybe New York, whereas Bob take second qubit of the Bell state and moves to San Francisco. In the future, Alice wishes to send two classical bits to Bob. To that end, Alice will perform different operations on his portion of Bell state, and then whatever the result is, Alice will send that result to Bob. And then Bob will do some operation on his side and will retrieve two classical bits that Alice wanted to send to Bob. We call this preparing of the Bell state. This we call Alice encoding, and this we call a Bob decoding. So let's see all of those steps. In order to fully understand this circuit, I have divided this circuit in different stages, and we will see how our input transform through all those stages. First stage is catch psi 1, second is catch psi 2, and the final stage is catch psi 3. So let's start. We start with catch 00 pure state and use that pure state to create Bell state. In the start, Alice and Bob are both together and they are making Bell state. So catch psi 1 is catch 00. We are done with this state, and this small circuit creates Bell state. At catch psi 2, we will get a Bell state, and we have seen this circuit before, so I'm not explaining this circuit again here. So in catch psi 2, we will get catch 00 plus catch 11 divided by square root of 2. So this is my catch psi 2. So I'm done with this stage of the circuit. The catch psi 3 stage depends upon what Alice wishes to send to Bob. Let's see, if Alice wishes to send catch 00, then Alice will do no operation on his portion of Bell state and send it as it is to Bob. So in that case, our catch psi 3 will be equal to catch psi 2, that will be cat 00 plus cat 11 divided by square root of 2. If Alice wishes to send cat 01, then Alice will apply poly X gate on his portion of Bell state. So Alice will perform poly X gate on his portion of Bell state. Poly X gate, also known as NOT gate, because it changes 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. Poly X gate in the matrix form can be written as 0, 1 and 1, 0. And if I give get 1 to poly X gate, then it will produce get 0. If I give get 0 to poly X gate, then my answer will be get 1. So it changed 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. So now I apply poly X gate on cat psi 2. My first qubit will flip from 0 to 1, and second will remain the same. Similarly, this one will flip from 1 to 0, and second will remain the same. So this will be my cat psi 3. If Alice wishes to send 10, two classical bit 10 to Bob, then Alice will perform poly Z gate on his portion of Bell state. Poly Z gate on cat's eye too. Poly Z gate change the phase of input. If we apply Poly Z gate on cat 0, then my answer remains cat 0. However, if I apply Poly Z gate on cat 1, then my answer is minus cat 1. So now we have to apply Poly Z gate on our bell state. So our cat psi 3 will be that we will have 0, 0, because 0 will remain 0. And in case of cat 1, 1, it will change the sign of this cat 1. So we will get minus cat 1, 1 divided by square root of 2. So we are done with three possibilities. That is, if Alice wishes to send 0, 0, then she will do no operation. If Alice wishes to send 0, 1, then she will apply Poly X gate. If Alice wishes to send 1, 0, then she will apply Poly Z gate. Now, if Alice wishes to send 1, 1, then she will do two operations on his portion of bell state. First, she will apply Poly Z gate on cat psi 2. Now, whatever the result, she will apply Poly X gate on the result. So now let's see how these two operations will work. We already have result of this thing, that when Poly X Z gate is being applied on cat psi 2. This is our result. Now we say X and this one, which is 0, 0 minus X 1, 1 divided by square root of 2. And we know that X gate changes cat 0 to 1 and cat 1 to 0. That means that our result going to be 1, 0 minus 0, 1 divided by square root of 2. Now Alice has completed her encoding, and after completing her encoding, Alice will send her portion of bell state to Bob. Now Bob will get one qubit from Alice, and Bob already has other portion of bell state, and Bob will perform some operations on both of those qubits. We call these operations Bob decoding, and after operation Bob will measure the result, and hopefully the result will be whatever Alice wishes to send to Bob. So now let's see what will be our cat psi 4. In this case, when Alice has sent this qubits to Bob, Alice has sent only the first one, but Bob also has the second one. So in sum, Bob has both of those qubits. Now Bob will perform first C note on those qubits, and then Bob will perform Hadamard gate on the first qubit. Let's apply C note on cat 0, 0 plus cat 1, 1 divided by square root of 2. In C note, if the first qubit is 0, second qubit remains the same. When first qubit is 1, the second qubit flips, because C note is a control node gate. Our answer is going to be 0, 0 plus 1, 0 divided by square root of 2. Now we will apply Hadamard gate, because here first we apply C note gate, and now we're applying Hadamard gate, but only on the first qubit. So we apply Hadamard gate on the first qubit. Our answer is going to be, in this case, cat 0 plus cat 1 divided by square root of 2, and this cat 0 will remain the same. And because we already have here a square root of 2, and then this square root 2, when multiplied with this square root 2, we will get 2 here. Plus Hadamard gate on cat 1, we'll get cat 0 minus cat 1 divided by, once again, we have this square root 2, and we also have another square root 2 because of Hadamard gate. So we'll have here 2 multiplied by cat 0. We'll simplify it. We will get 0, 0 plus cat 1, 0 plus cat 0, 0, and we will get minus cat 1, 1 divided by 2, and this cannot be correct. I have done some mistake somewhere. So this should be 1, 0. This should be 1, 0 because of this. Now these two will cancel each other and my result will be 2 get 0 0 divided by 2, which is 0 0. So now when Bob measures the result, our result going to be 0 0 with 100% probability. That means this case we have verified that it actually works, and our cat psi 4 is going to be 0 0. So because I have less space on the board, so I'm going to erase it and just going to write that cat psi 4 in this case is going to be cat 0 0. Now in this case we have to see what will be our cat psi 4. We will apply first a C node gate on this, and then we will apply Hadamard gate on the first qubit. So when we apply C node gate, then our result is going to be that when we have 1, second qubit will flip. When we have 0, second qubit will remain the same. So our result going to be 1, 1 plus 0, 1 divided by square root of 2. So we have applied C node gate, but we yet have to apply Hadamard gate on these qubits. So now we apply Hadamard gate, our cat psi 4 in this case is going to be, we apply Hadamard gate on cat 1, it will be cat 0 plus cat 1, sorry, minus cat 1 and divided by 2 because of this under root 2, and we will have here 1, this cat 1 plus, we apply Hadamard gate on cat 0, we will get cat 0 plus cat 1 divided by 2, and then we will have cat 1. We simplify it, we will get cat 0 1 minus cat 1 1 plus cat 0 1 plus cat 1 1 divided by 2, and then these two will cancel. Our result is going to be cat 0 1. Now in this case our cat psi 4 is 0 1. When Bob measures this cat psi 4, then with 100% probability, Bob will measure 0, 1 because it is a pure state. We don't have any other option. Similarly, in the last two cases, which I'm not going to do because they are similar, but in this case, our cat psi 4 will be equals to 1, 0. And in this case, our cat psi 4 is going to be cat 1, 1. So although it is a very simple protocol which use only some basic gates and it doesn't have lots of logic in it, but it helps us to understand how to use quantum gates. It introduces us to an application of entanglement. So I hope that you will be able to understand this superdense coding. And if you have any questions, please ask those questions. See you next time. Bye.